Welcome to antenna and wave propagation playlist. Here in this session I'll be going to explain Hansen and Woodyard end fire array. So in this session I'll explain what is that change which is been done in array of element to have improved directivity that is been provided by Hansen and Woodyard end fire array. So for end fire array, we can find maxima position, that is there at 0 degree angle and at 180 degree angle. But by using this Hansen and Woodyard array, one can have improved directivity of array. So let us try to understand how Hansen Woodyard have provided improved directivity to end fire array. So here I have considered one array of four elements. So here we have four elements. This is first element, second element, third element and fourth element. And all four elements are separated by lambda by 4 distance. So phase between each element that we can calculate as per alpha is equals to minus beta d. Now here if we place values, then beta is 2 pi by lambda and spacing between element, that is lambda by 4. So ultimately this is resulting into lambda is getting cancelled and this is minus pi by 4. So that is actually minus 90 degree. So if you observe phase difference in between elements, then that phase difference, that is 90 degree in case of 4 point array. And if you observe radiation characteristic by this 4 element array, then that will look like this. And there are some side lobes that one can observe here. So this will be the radiation characteristic which is there as per this arrangement, where second element is having 90 degree phase with respect to first, third is having 90 degree phase with respect to second. So that is how this arrangement is there. But as per Hansen and Woodyard, they have suggested phase, by modifying phase we can be able to provide higher directivity. So Hansen and Woodyard have suggested if you have phase alpha is equals to, instead of only beta d, there is pi by n. So ultimately by adding this additional parameter here, we can be able to provide improved directivity of array. So here as per this basic 4 element array, we can say beta, that is 2 pi by lambda, d is lambda by 4, plus here 4 elements are there, so pi by 4. So this will be pi by 2 plus pi by 4, means 90 degree plus 45 degree. So that will result into minus 135 degree. So by providing additional 45 degree phase to successive elements, one can be able to have improved directivity. Now if you provide additional this phase of 45 degree in arrangement of 4 element array, in that case we can have improved directivity of radiation pattern by 4 elements. So what exactly the case which we need to do? For example, here by lambda by 4 spacing, already 90 degree phase is there, but additional 45 degree phase that we need to add over here. And 2 to 3, already 90 degree phase is there, but additional 45 degree phase that we need to add it to third element. 90 degree phase is there, but additional 45 degree phase that we need to add it to fourth element. So that is how one can design this Hansen Woodyard array. So in this we need to connect phase shifter with each element to provide initial phase, that is pi by n. So when you see radiation characteristic by this modified phase which is there with Hansen Woodyard array, then you will be finding like its radiation characteristic will be like this, and this lobe that will get nullify in this Hansen Woodyard array. So you will be finding it appears like this, and side lobes are even getting suppressed. So with this directivity one can send signal to larger distance. So this is what improved directivity with respect to normal four element array which is there with end fire pattern. Now let us have one more example, so it will be pretty much clear how we can design this. So here we have 8 elements. This is first element, this is second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh and eighth. So we have total 8 number of elements here in array. Now as per basic calculation, phase difference in between successive element that we can calculate as per alpha is equals to minus beta d. So that is beta is 2 pi by lambda, and d in this end fire pattern it should be lambda by 2. So this will be minus pi, means it will be 1 minus 180 degree. So phase difference in between successive element that will be minus 180 degree in this case. And for that case if you plot a radiation pattern, then that radiation pattern for end fire arrangement will be somewhat like this, and there are some minor lobes like this. Now by using Hansen Woodyard array, that phase that should be recalibrated to minus beta d plus pi by n. So this is what we have already calculated. So that is pi, and here 8 elements are there, so pi by 8. So ultimately one can say this is 180 degree plus pi by 8 means 180 by 8, so that has to be 22.5. so this phase that will be now 202.5 degree. So if you provide additional 22.5 degree phase to successive elements, then it will be Hansen Woodyard array pattern, and in that one can observe radiation characteristic that will change to somewhat this, where this back lobe that will get nullified and side lobes that is getting suppressed like this. So ultimately now with this lobe one can say it is having improved directivity. So this is how Hansen Woodyard have explained how we can improve directivity by having additional phase of pi by n with individual successive elements. So here by having a path difference of lambda by 2, already phase difference of 180 degree is there from 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4. Likewise elements are having phase of 180 degree. But to get improved directivity by adding this phase pi by n, one can have improved radiation pattern like this. So for 4 element as well as for 8 element we have already seen. Now for other array one we can think about it. So this is what the basic understanding which is there with Hansen Woodyard array. Thank you so much for watching this video. You can share these videos to your friends to have better understanding of antenna and wave propagation. You can find all lectures regarding different types of antenna with this playlist. And you can find materials, which is what I am teaching here, on my website, and link of that website is attached with this description of video. So just go through it once. Thank you so much for watching this video.